Love. So this video will have three parts. One will actually show how to close the rifts and give a few explanations. The other one will be about the oasis, how to upgrade it, how to trade and how to do other stuff or what you're supposed to do with it. And the last part will be just us, you know, enjoying the dialogue and speaking with these people, searching for the entire ship and looking at stuff. But for now, let's do everything very, very fast. Now, what is the best way to search for the Octomian ship? Well, to be honest, it's kind of like a little cheese mod, but for example, you have a quit and a safe quit, so when you are full stats, simply go out of your base and save the game. Search, for example, all of the north areas. If you don't find anything, just quit. Yes, you will not save your game, and then click on resume. It's kind of like a cheese. I don't think this will make it into the full release of the game, but for now that's how it works. You have a save and quit, and you have a quit. So if you didn't find it in the north, let's say, you reload your game and search in the west, in the south, and so on. Now, from what I can see, the ship will sometimes spawn in the north area, or most of the times, I don't know, I only found it once. But it seems like the other areas are a little bit too more dangerous for it to crash there. Another problem is the first time you find the ship, you'll see something like this. And you'll only see the pillars. And you might think, well, you scan the pillars.
Would you look at that? What an impressive ship.
It is.
Alright. I'll start the... Wow. They wouldn't. Thank you.
Unknown. Okay, so what's the problem with this? If you search it like this, you'll not get the icon for the overseer, for the Octomian base. So I recommend you fully search it, because I actually lost track of it. See? This is how it looks on the minimap. If you have the weather effect on it, you'll not be able to see it. And if you don't fully explore its shape, you kind of will lose it. So yeah. After you speak with the overseer, you'll get the better icon. But until then, well, just have to craft something to analyze the shield. It doesn't show anymore, but you need a Viper Lisk tooth. You need one of these things and some other things, but don't worry, it's not too hard to get it. Now, after you find the base, you speak with the overseer.
This ship is amazing.
Like I said, I will show you all of the dialogue in the last part of the video, but for now, let's just close one of the rifts. Then it will tell you to speak with Sense. Which apparently he hides sometimes, but he should be around here in this area. Inquisitor? Sense, here it is. Again, I'll skip it and I'll redo the dialogue in the final part of the video. And this is the quest. So first of all, you'll have the unexpected guest, force field analyzer. Well, like I said, it doesn't show up in the research because I already did that. And then you have to kind of upgrade your scanner. It's not an item, it's just an upgrade of your scanner. Meet the leader, talk to Sense, and then you get the second quest. Talk to Sense to see what he wants.
So what's this
talk? Again, just track the quest. Because you might leave the ship without getting the full dialogue. And then you get here, the Rift Repairer. Now, let's close the rift. As a little warning, you should be closed only the rifts that are super important. For example, the rift I will close should be this one. Because it hinders my... kind of like my access to the oasis. As for using the rift repairer, well, it's not so hard. But see what happens if you fail? You die. If you get too close to it. So let's do that again without dying, and this time I'll show you kind of like the right way to do it. Because initially I thought you have to go very, very deep into the void, into the rift. But apparently you don't even have to go that close, you just have to deploy it near the edge of it.
This ship is amazing.
Sorry for the repetition, but I just wanted to show you the dangers, because you will need a good save game. If you don't have a good save game before you do this, you might die, you might lose everything, and then you have to go back to your body. And also, Sense will sometimes hide.
Alright.
So let's get the quest. Now, before you go and close the rift, you can also choose where to close it, but then you'll have to come back to the ship, so think about that. Make sure your stats are full. Let's say something like this. And this time let's close it for good. Now, as you can see, the ship is very far away from my base. So yeah, be careful with that. And that's it, you close the rift. Hooray for us. Now, I think you can just leave it at the edge and nothing bad will happen, but sometimes if you are careless like I was the first time, you'll actually get killed. And if you don't have... Well, if you don't have resources, if you're not prepared for this phase of the game, you'll not have a very, very fun time. Also, is there any point in doing this early on besides closing a rift? Well, not really, because finding the ship can be very time consuming. Exploring the other areas might also be a priority because you need a lot of resources and... Let's see what Sense is.
Great news, Sense. Did you... Yes.
And besides the closing of one free rift, there's not much reason to do it. I mean, I had 4 rift left, and now I have 4. 3, and now I have 4. So I closed one. Now, what happens if you close the first rift, if you do the quest? Well, you get other quests. Complete Void Toxicity, Complete Void Power Research, and also Complete Void Origins Research. Which is not so bad, but... You need a lot of stuff. For example, as the Runekeeper, this is the easiest one. Scanning the warriors is easy if you did it before, and also the void power, it's easy if you have all of this resource. So, what I'm trying to say is that there is almost no point into finding the ship very early into the game. I recommend you try searching for the ship only after you do the main quest of the Brachylon and Oasis. So that means enabling the trade, delivering 20 texts, and also the stuff for the warriors and the first aid kit, which will give you this one completed, and then you'll go into the next phase, which you have to fabricate these items. And fabricating those items will not be easy at all. As you can see, you'll need another Vipolestos tooth, of course, bull croc horn, which is the huge bull. Probably know what the Vipolisk is at this point. It's that giant snake that is in the Scorchlands or the Decaying West. I'm not sure, because the Bleach Sands, it seems to be on the border of these for me, so it might be in one of them, but I'm not sure exactly where. Bull Croc, you just need to go probably to the plains, and remember, you have the Croc, and then you have the Bull Croc, that's what you needed. Now, why am I showing you this? Because it's very important that you kind of know how to finish the mid search section of the game, or the second part of the game. Now, the Corvex side, you probably know it's the Corvex in the Fallen Frostlands. It's just a huge animal over here in the Fallen Frostlands. Croghide, Crogs, we know. For this you need what is called the matter printer to make the Polykin fabric. The Claw of Power, find Keterium, just Keterium is okay, Gravite is easy to find. Sarad, Metallic, Satar, Metallic, Chitin. It might be the ones that... Oh, hold on, let's actually search a bit. Might be the ones in the far north or in the south, near the fiery areas. Satarad, okay, that's what they're called. Probably in the Boiling Springs, I'm not sure if they're in any other area. They might be in other areas as well. But those are the Plasma Pots and the other beetles.
I'm running low on oxygen.
Ah, that's not a problem. We reload the game anyway. So I'm not sure if there are in other areas as well. Ah, probably not, but I showed you where to get them. So, why should you do the first quest, the quest for the Brachylon first? Well, simply put, you'll have a very hard time doing all of this. Or no, let's show it like this, doing all of this. But I'm doing the first quest because they're actually tied together and you'll not have enough resources to survive for a long time unless you enable trading. So let's go over here, quit, and let's go to the second part of the video. Now the second part of the video we will mostly be covering the Brachylon and the Oasis and why you should upgrade it and why you need to go there every time. And also, if the resources are so limited, how do you get other resources? Teleporter is a must at this point. I was also very slowed my game because it's a very very hard map since the Oasis is so far away from us. Inhale, exhale. Also, I'm using the Mega Pack, which is great. Well, I would cook a steak, but we have a lot of work to do in the video, so next time maybe. So, the Brachylon is the main quest of the game. I mean, a lot of people will think closing the rift is the main objective of the game, but it's not. The main objective of the game is to actually upgrade the base, the Oasis, the base of the Brachylon, so you will have access to other resources once your perishable or your final resources finish. I mean, for example, the Polkin ore, it's very rare. If you see a mine, just get it and keep it. You'll need a lot of it. The Feron ore is a lot more common. Yeah. I like this one. So this is the rift I'll close on my game. The Void Crystal and the other stuff are not so hard to get. Also, Gas Blossom Vine is a healing item. Oops. Oh, this is actually not a dead end. I know my map. And this is what I confused for the ship. As you can see, all of the outlines are colored like that, so the ship outline will appear something like that. So if you don't explore the whole area, you won't know. Hazard protection critical. And then the acid pits. Okay, that was quite a long run, sorry about that, but yeah. Kind of like an obstacle course. It's also very important to come to the base regularly because you will have the gamble cactuses, which are easy to collect. Oh, I have a lot of them over there. So if you collect all of the cactuses, you'll have a lot of food, a lot of healing, because if you eat all of the fruits, you'll have a lot of healing. Oxygen, of course, is plentiful, the obelisk. And now, why should you do the quest first? Well, simply put, we have a trader over here who refreshes his stock every day, every single day. So that means the trader has refreshed its stock for 48 times, 48 days. Now, I didn't upgrade everything because it was quite hard to get over to this point. To start upgrading, you actually need to give the Roomkeeper the sacred scrolls or the texts. You might not need to give the... I'm not sure if it's a requirement in order to upgrade. In order to upgrade the market, but I did that first of all because you don't want to lose a lot of time with this one. So over here you have the upgrade. I think you can upgrade the marketplace even before you make the quest, but I don't know. Just to be on the sure side, I completed it first. Trading. So, if you upgrade the hunting parts, you'll be able to buy meat and other bug parts, botany, of course, plants. Smithy, you can buy weapons from this place, which is huge, because later on in the game, you'll actually see that your weapons are kind of bad. So let's talk a bit about the weapons. What weapons do we have available to you? Well, you have the Shock Coil, which is actually great, but it doesn't do a lot of damage. It's a rich weapon, can reach quite a bit of distance with that, but it also requires the tubing, which is Polkin ore, and most likely you lose the Polkin ore or the tubing for the healing items. So yeah, it's kind of a trick you want to build in large numbers. And then you just have the other thing, which is the security button. The damage is similar, I think the button does a little more damage, but you'll not be able to kill the crabman with this weapon, so I think you will be able to buy, let's say the Void Hand Axe. It has a power-up attack and a faster attack. Sometimes they seem... running out of air. No, it's the same speed, I was wrong. So if you click once, you'll actually go into this animation and you'll hit. It does a lot of damage, but it's very slow. And then the Voilands. I actually got them from fighting and killing the crabmen. The decaying waste are a great place, so I found these two corrupted territories over here. And also let a few Viper risk into that. Then also the meteors do damage to them as well, so it was not so hard to get 20 text. Eating raw meat will actually decrease your health. So yeah, I think you'll be able to buy these weapons later on from the marketplace, or even better ones. The same for the armor. So there are more weapons in the game, but you will need to buy them. Livestock trade. Small creatures as pets or food. Well, I'm curious what pets they have, but you'll surely have the Spark Sprite. Let me see, we'll surely have the Spark Sprite, which are a source of electricity, which is great, because you will no longer have to, I don't know, manually get them. Let me see where they are. Anyway, they are the guys that appear in the Geode quarries. Shock Sprite, probably other creatures as well, I'm not sure, probably the chitons. That also means you can get them and kill them for their chitin. Now let's see some other options. What else can we get from them? Probably the important one is the weapons. Crystal gathering, in case you run out of crystals in your area, you can gather some crystals, and also basic mining. And that probably is the Polkin War. This is probably one of the most important ones you'll need to get, because you can get them very early and it will be very important. Also, what should you buy every day from them? Well, this is a healing item. These are healing items as well, but Dantos is important, but you can buy 2 med gels per day from them, which is crazy. The med gel is super rare and super hard to get in your game, so you'll have to buy them, and then you'll be able to buy weapons as well and other resources. So most likely the end game will be you only trading, and what can you sell to them? Almost everything you can sell to them, even the text you can sell to them, but I don't recommend that. Most of the time you just sell the timber, which will be 5 gold or 5 shields. Let's also make a cloth.
Do you know anything about those giant crab?
Yes, they know everything. So let's sell the temper cloth. Let's see how much we get. Oh, we get 18. So I guess it's just a lot better to sell the timber cloth. Don't sell it as it is, don't sell the timber. Sell the timber cloth. Also the Rolex muscles from the insects, so everything you collect is probably sellable. Well, sadly I don't have enough, they just rotted away in my inventory. Probably the more you upgrade the market, the more stuff you can sell to them as well. Also, if you don't know what to sell the first time, I recommend Ember Crystal, so that's 26, 49. So that's 14 shields, and Ember Crystal, you don't need large quantities, but it's pretty easy to find. So yeah, don't sell the Bloom Crystals because they're rarer. Don't sell the Face Crystals because you might need them to research other stuff. So yeah, Ember Crystals are a sure thing to sell. Also, you can cook them and then sell them. And then you can just buy the Med Gel every day, and that's how you're supposed to handle your healing, your weapons and some other stuff later. Now, like I said in the beginning of the video, this is kind of like the most important thing you need to do. Explore Keten to find a way to fix the wall forge. That will be a little later. I'm not sure how you fix it, but I'll play more and I'll tell you about it. Also, these things are not so hard to make at my current game level and so on. So like I said, now we'll just quit the game and we'll actually go and read the whole story of the Octomians, or whatever you want to call them. Sorry about this being a longer video, but I just wanted to explain some basic mechanics because this is only the mid game and it's day 40, so
oxygen warning.
Yeah, I think we'll have a lot of other things left to do. Oh, did I say save and quit instead of I might have made a mistake. Oh well. That happens when you're speaking a lot and you don't actually pay attention to what you're doing.
Oxygen warning.
Well, not a problem, we didn't waste a lot of resources anyway. So let's teleport back, actually, I was thinking, don't do that, don't do that, and I did it. Also, some biomes are a lot more dangerous in the night. Ah, don't worry too much, we will be okay. But save and quit is probably the one you'll choose the most. Freezing doesn't do a lot of damage, but it will tick off very, very annoyingly. It's so well hidden. And now let's read the dialogue.
This ship is amazing.
Or listen to it.
I've never seen anything like it in my life. Who are you guys? Oh, I so don't know if I'm ready to handle this. Right. My name is Quinn Hicks, Science Officer representing Space Corps. I am so relieved to find you guys. I need help. Well, I would be happy to help, and I would love to learn more about you Octomians, but I need help to save the people of this planet, and your ship can accomplish that. All right. I'll hold you to your word on this. You're really my only hope here. I'll find this sense and get the details.
Well, he speaks of himself as the Overseer, so that's why you'll say the Overseer is at whatever. Definitely different way of approaching... anyway, it's just a matter of speech, it's not...
Oxygen warning.
Oh, sense can also go over here, that's new.
You're doing fine. So, you guys are here to figure out what that energy swirling around the planet can do? Nutrients, warning. Really? They don't seem like the aggressive type. I'm pretty curious too, so what do you guys need me to do? I'm itching to get started. The Overseer agreed to help save the people here afterwards. I think I'm getting pretty good at handling danger, but I'll get ready and speak to you when I'm good to go. Oxygen low.
Okay, that's nice, we'll speak with him again, but first, I want to get something for the... yeah. This is perfect. Okay, let's see what sense is.
Alright, so what's this top secret mission? My... I don't have one of those. I'll freeze outside at night. None. I have an augmented reality AI assistant, if that counts. He usually just tells me to research things.
Oxygen, critical.
Oh, thanks for the offer, but I'll pass for now. Okay, maybe I'm a little curious. But let's get back on track. My stomach is killing me. I need food. We can close those death spirals? Great! I'll deploy this device in...
anywhere within. To deploy it, not throw it.
Oxygen depleted.
Wait. And that's kind of like the mid portion of the game, how to close the rifts, how to interact with the Octomians, how to upgrade the Brachylon, the Oasis, and why it's so important to have actually a kind of like a set goal in mind. First of all, the Brachylon, the Oasis, and then the Octomians, and then you can do them together. You probably have enough tools and technology research at this point to do all of them at the same time, which will actually save a lot of time if you think about it. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.